Hi, welcome back. This is my messy palette. You see that? Mostly using primaries at the moment, so I've just done a real abstract of it looks more like Monet's garden or something like that. But here I've primed the board with PVA glue and sprinkled on some of this easy fill, I think it's gypsum plaster. It doesn't shrink when you fill cracks with it, and the customer gave me a pot full of it in his Quaker Oats pot, and I'm trying it, and it stays moist. Well, the powder doesn't dry quickly like plaster of Paris, so it's all very experimental. It's quite lumpy. I like it like that. That's just the way we're doing it at the moment. Right, I'm going to use, I'll use this inch brush, this acrylic brush, made for acrylics, short flat. I use it mostly in watercolour to do straight lines. But I want to do a Cornish type of scene. So grey rocks, so a bit of white, a bit of red, a bit of yellow, and mostly red. So we'll just some rocks. I'll just find some greys here. Did I say I'll prime it with yellow ochre? So some of the sand will show through in this. Right, let's get this a bit of dark in there. So cool. Okay, then we're going with some waves over that. The horizon fairly low. Or below halfway anyway. So we just put in a bit of sea. And then we can drag the sky over that. I want a dark outline there to separate from the sea. Right, now I want to put in some light there. Some like light grey. To show some planes of the rock. Nice, but red's lovely to put in, but very easy to overdo, but too much in. Yeah, sort of an abstract shape. Right, now we'll go in with the colours. So I'll use this brush here. So, nice. Dark overhead. And we're getting some, oops. A bit of yellow's gone into that. I'm just going to squirt out some more of my white. I bought another pot of this, it's for £14, it's quite expensive, but it's artist quality. Clean the brush. Take that one out. Now I should really use that one throughout, shouldn't I? So give it a good clean. That's the inch. Acrylic brush. System 3, Dale Rowney, short flat. They're very good quality. Right, let's just get a bit of grey in there. Let's have a bit of yellow and red, a bit of orangey. Mix it with that. Just get over the sea. Bring your sea into the sky and sky into the sea. Same with the rocks, drag over. And that should be more bluey, greeny now, I think. That's a bit more sea colour. Some in here. Right, keep the brush clean. Get the nice bit of colour in here. So merge. Over there. Right. Dark. This is my 1,000th video. That's taken just over 3 years to do that. I wasn't setting any records, it just happened that I've been quite busy on the paintings for the 3 years. But I don't spend days painting. I get it out of my system in a couple of videos here and there. Then I reckon I've earned a little rest. Okay, so let's just put in more colour in those clouds, a bit of red and yellow, just primary. A nice bit on the brush. Does that look right? Yeah, that's not bad. Gonna start piling in the white. Jack that spray over there. A little bit. Okay. Right, now trying to leave some of this yellow ochre to show through as sand. I've been looking at Jackie Gardner's albums and getting ideas in. But I don't copy, I do my own thing. We pick up ideas from wherever we can get them. That's how you learn. Oh, just a bit of a catch of light coming up the cliff here. I will put in some shadow, shadowy greens. Don't want to overdo these. Show some shadow in your crashing wave. And then coming over there. Okay. Now there's too much green in that top here, so let's just pick out some little spray in white. And then we can put in a bit of shadow, or a bit of reflection, sorry, in the wet sand here, of those rocks. And then show a bit of reflection of these in here. Showing in there. Oh, it's all lovely wet sand. Right, okay, so let's see if we can make something of that overhead cloud, that darker cloud. I want white, I'm trying to get away from that white. Okay. To try to eliminate shapes that you don't like, that are just obviously not very good. Just that little bit, it just sort of shows. Okay, I'll put that in a mount or in the frame, see if it's any good. The frame adds 50% to the picture. And it gives you an idea of what it would look like should it ever end up in a frame. Right, I'm just going to wipe the bottom of the That's just a little bit too big for the frame, which is a bit of a shame, but can't do much about that. I will trim it lengthwise, which will be quite shortly. Oh, well, there we are, that looks quite, let's come around here. Well, that doesn't look so bad, does it? Let's zoom in. Around there. You can see a lovely texture I've got on the board under the paint. And leaving some of the ground colour, the yellow ochre, to show through, shows a bit of a sandy beach underneath the high tide and the crashing waves. So that's all I've done for the sky. Oops. Just dragged over, really. Okay, 1000. Well, I hope you enjoy that. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.